How many passwords do you have? 10? 20? 100? Well, if you're like me, I've got 750 unique passwords, strongly chosen, and thankfully I don't have to remember most of them. I'll let you in on the secret. So, how do most people solve that problem? It's a problem that was created by the security department, who had good intentions of making you choose strong passwords. But strong passwords are generally hard to remember. So what we end up with is this thing that has been referred to as the PC sunflower. It looks like this. It's a display monitor with a lot of little yellow stickies all around it, each one of them with a user ID and password. Obviously not a very secure solution. What is a potentially other alternative that people do? Sometimes they take all those passwords, don't put them on the monitor on the little yellow stickies. Instead, they put them in an insecure file, like say a flat file, an Excel spreadsheet, or even an email to themselves. Also, not a good solution. Or the third alternative most users choose if left to their own devices is they set all the passwords to the same thing, which again, not a good choice, because if you are able to figure out the password on one system, you get it on all. The whole thing falls like a house of cards. So what are the alternatives? Well, let's look at why we have this problem in the first place. So we've got a user here who needs to log in to, let's say, a number of different systems down here. So this is system one, system two, system in. Now this user needs to log in, so they're having to log in here with password one, they log in here with password two, they log in here with password in. And the guy is up here with this issue because he can't remember all of these passwords. So that's why he went with those other solutions that I was talking about, which are not secure. They're not getting us to where we want to be. And the user has this conundrum of trying to figure out how they can solve the problem. Now, what's a better alternative? Well, let's put that user over here, and this time we'll have him log in to his multiple systems, system one, two, and in. Except in this case, he's going to not log directly into the system, he's going to log into a thing I'm going to call a single sign-on manager. This is a special tool, software usually, that's designed so that you log into this with a single password that you've chosen that's complex, and then it remembers the passwords for all of these other systems. So we have a unique password for each one of these systems. So this would be password one. Actually, this would be password A to get you into the single sign-on. This is password two, and this is password in. So now we have a case where the user has to keep up with only one password, which is good news for that user. Now they feel this way. One password to get into all of the systems. So that makes their user experience much better. Now, what's the problem with this? Some people would argue, security types often do this, that now you've introduced a single point of failure. In other words, if someone figures out this password, they can log in here and therefore get access to all the others. Well, I'm going to say first of all to the people that express this objection, have you ever met one of these guys? Do you know how they're solving their problem? Remember what I told you, they're putting them in insecure places? Or if they're not doing that, they're setting password one to password two to password in. They're choosing a single password for everything anyway. So it's the same problem. The difference is, if it's the same password in this scenario, then knowing the password here means you know the password here and here, and they all fall. In this case, if someone knows the password here because they were able to hack that system, they do not know what these passwords are because they're unique. So what that does for us is lessens the attack surface to a single system at a time. And if you say, but how do I protect this? Now we're going to do that with multi-factor authentication. With this now, it's not a single password that gets you in, it's also something you have, or something you know, or something you are. It's some combination of those things. So now I have a secure gateway into this system, and there it unlocks all the rest. So with a solution with single sign-on, we end up with some distinct benefits. One of those is we end up with better security. Better security for the reasons I just talked about. That is, we don't have one system falls and they all fall. Now we have one system falls and that's the extent of the damage. We have a better savings cost-wise. Why is that? Well, it turns out if a user has only one password to remember, they're much more likely to remember it, therefore not forget it, therefore not need to call into the help desk in order to get it reset. And the statistics tell us that the number one call to most help desks is reset my password. Sometimes it's as much as 50% of the calls into the help desk. That means half of your help desk call is just supporting the password reset problem that we can lessen and if we used a single sign-on solution. And then at the end of the day, we also get an improved user experience. This user has only one thing to remember. Therefore, they don't need the PC Sunflower, they don't need the Excel side file, they don't need to set all their passwords to the same thing and compromise security. So this is one of these rare situations that we need to jump on because we actually get to improve security, lower costs, and improve the user experience. Thanks for watching. Please remember to like this video and subscribe to this channel so we can continue to bring you content that matters to you.